Welcome back to another glimpse into Shanghai's rich and varied culture. Standing here today, we are at the entrance of one of China's top 10 film and TV production bases, known as the Shanghai Film Park. The film park is home to numerous European-style buildings, the Suzhou Creek landscape, and a fascinating glimpse into the Nanxing Road's history during the 1930s. Upon first entering the park, visitors enter a European-style courtyard graced by a Rococo statue and a number of other buildings decorated in a unique European style. Heading deeper into the park, visitors come to the Muller Villa, known for its Northern European architecture. The original architectural version can be seen at the intersection of the Middle Yan Road and South Songxi Road in Shanghai. The Muller Villa was built by Eric Muller and was intended to be his daughter's dream house as well as a commemoration of his early life. The exterior is a notable Norwegian style with stylish red refractory bricks and gorgeous yellow-green glazed roof tiles. It is these details that catch visitor eyes as well as drawing attention to the blend of Chinese and European architectural styles in the villa. On display in a different area of the park is a nearly exact replica of the Waibaidu Bridge. The Waibaidu Bridge, also called the Garden Bridge, was built over the Suzhou Creek. During its construction, it marked the northern boundary of the famous Shanghai Bund. Though the replica is much smaller than the original Waibaidu Bridge, it has been used in numerous films and TV shows with its unique charm. Running through the Shanghai Film Park is a unique cobblestone road, a holdover from the 1950s when as many as 400 cobblestone roads ran through Shanghai. Visitors love strolling along the road and immersing themselves into this quaint look into Shanghai's past. In 1933, the Paramount Ballroom opens its doors, becoming the most popular entertainment venue in old Shanghai. Though the ballroom here at the film park is just a replica, it still provides a lingering charm and accurate representation of old Shanghai. The largest dance floor within the ballroom spanned more than 500 square meters, which meant almost 1,000 people could comfortably dance at the same time. Perhaps the most famous visitors to the Paramount Ballroom included the world-renowned comic Charlie Chaplin, who visited together with his wife in 1936, experiencing the automotive leaf spring-supported floor for themselves. Another featured attraction inside the Shanghai Film Park is this beautiful mural depicting a German bar, and it's not very difficult for visitors to imagine people from all over the world gathering together in camaraderie. The now famous Nanxing Road wasn't always known by the name it is today, and was once a narrow street called Garden Lane, or sometimes Park Lane. Running less than 500 meters, the Garden Lane was reconstructed during the British settlement of 1851. It was China's first road in what is now the modern age. Located at the northwest corner of the intersection of Nanxing Road and Zhisheng Road, the New World City connects the vibrant shopping district of East Nanxing Road to West Nanxing Road, and is now the site of the New World Amusement Park, completed in August of 1915. It was the first steel-framed commercial building in Shanghai during the 1900s. The first tram, before automobiles came to China, traveled along the Nanjing Road in March of 1908. It was a new and exciting thing for the people of Shanghai, who had long only witnessed two-wheeled vehicles pulled by people. The use of trams was short-lived, however, and the rise of automobiles rapidly overtook the use of trams. Visitors to the film park can also take a step into the past and view the Nanjing Road as it would have been in the 1930s. After the unveiling of the Sincere Company in 1917, the Nanjing Road grew into a busy shopping district with numerous Chinese shops, both old and new, combined with modern department stores. Popular stores included the Yong'an, Sun, The Sun, Shanghai Zhanxi Company, Shenda Chang Snack Shop, and Henry Watch Shop, all adding to the vibrant thrill of culture bound in Shanghai. Any visit to Shanghai is incomplete without a visit to the Shanghai Film Park, especially for film and history buffs. A tour of the film lot is both fun and informative, as well as an exciting glimpse into China, both as it was and as it is now.